The Biotron facility is a containment facility. It's been designed specifically for working with biocontrol agents. Was one of the things that we were particularly interested in. A little bit about global warming, climate change. We've got the 6 growth rooms in place at the moment. Combined with the downstairs part of the facility where we've got our rhizotron containers, it makes us a very functional facility in terms of plant growth and plant research and the soil interactions with those plants. The actual growth rooms themselves, the Conviron rooms, are very high spec. We can control the air temperature in these rooms from minus 10 through to 40 degrees. We have humidity control and dehumidification, very high light intensities, up to 1150 micromoles. We also have additive CO2, so we can work from ambient CO2 conditions right through to 2000 parts per million. All of these ante rooms have their own individual air supply that comes in through the ceiling. That air goes into the growth rooms and then it gets extracted out through hepa extraction systems. Researchers that we have in the facility are able to work in confidence knowing that other work in the facility actually has no effect on their experiments.
The facility here is either used for one or two purposes. It's either used as growth cabinets. We've run a number of experiments where we've done the above ground, below ground. In terms of what this system gives us, if you take a rhizotron and just put it into a growth chamber, right, then you would have whatever the temperature of the growth chamber was, that would be the temperature of the soil. And in reality, soil in the field is not like that. The soil at the surface is the same temperature as the air, sometimes a bit higher, but it decreases very rapidly as you go down. And that is what we tried to do here, was to create an environment where you had a real temperature profile going down, and that is controlled partly by the above ground conditions, but we also control the below ground conditions to get that proper variation or drop in temperature as you go down through the soil. If you want to do a large number of experiments, then you can actually create the conditions that are ideal for the disease. For example, it's a fungal disease, you want high humidity, you want high temperature, so you can do that here. Or for example, you might want to look at the same plant, the same disease, the same soil, the same, but different humidity and different temperature. Two rooms, two different, you can alter it. Technically, we could actually set up 6 different CO2 scenarios in here at the moment and run a set of experiments. We could have the same plant, same soil, and whatever, and I don't know anywhere that could do that in the world. There's nowhere, as far as I know, there's nobody else we could actually do that, again, using real systems and real rhizotrons. We were using Pinus radiata as a model plant, radiata pine, and what we were trying to do was we were looking at the influence of what we call root exudate, which is carbon that comes out of the roots, on microbial populations below ground. The work from that was really used to test out the systems and develop the methodology below ground, and that's where we started off, for example, with just a simple camera system for looking below ground so that we could look, but we couldn't sample, and that was where we came up with the idea of using a laparoscope. And it allows us to sample at different times, different places. It allows us to visualize things so we can actually take pictures of where the soil, where we're taking soil from and where we're sampling things from. And so that was a big advance, and that was very, very, very successful. And now we're moving on. Another experiment that we just done last year was actually using the control facilities of the Conviron to turn night into day, of course. So it means that you could, if we were looking at actually greenhouse gas nitrous oxide flow from grassland, and we were actually trying to measure how it changes with temperature and light. And this facility allows us to do that. And we did it in real rhizotron, so it was in real conditions, but it gave us the advantage of not going around in the middle of the night out in the field, right? We were able to control it. We were able to come here during the day, do the detailed experiments, and that's a real advantage. The experiments at the moment are primarily looking at what we call biological control, which is, for example, the focus on a particular disease. What they do is they then look for an organism, another organism that they might isolate from a soil or from somewhere else that they culture up, and then they assess a whole range of organisms who actually control that and formulate them, concentrate them, put them, for example, as I say, onto seeds, and hopefully that will reduce the incidence of disease in the plants.
In terms of running an experiment, it means that we can have replicated experiments in each of those growth rooms and be confident that the conditions that those plants are experiencing or that soil environment is experiencing are all exactly the same. So it's very reassuring for us.